Yes, if you want it and you commit to the actions required to make it happen. You mention, so first of all, I'm sorry about your friend, and the grief is part and parcel of letting someone go sometimes, so I don't think there's any need to have to try and speed up your grief process, because as we know, grief comes and goes and has its own journey with all of us and tells us when it's time to stop grieving. It comes and goes in waves. Regarding the connection that you had with your friend, that's great that you are celebrating this connection you had with your friend. No, you will never have exactly the same connection that you had with this friend with someone else, because they are a unique person and you had a unique chemical reaction because they are unique and you are unique. But what you can replicate, and in fact how the universe works, is if we hit a new level of something, so let's say we hit a new level of fulfillment in a relationship. Wow, I didn't know that being in a relationship could actually feel this fulfilling. That's a whole new mark for our mind. Our mind, that used to think relationships weren't that fulfilling, has suddenly been shown, oh wow, relationship can be fulfilling. So then, when we go out looking for a relationship again, we're no longer going out with part of our story being, oh well, relationships aren't really fulfilling, but I'm going on this dating website because Lee told me it would be good to take some action, so I'm trying. And you can see in the way that I demonstrate that energy that all of that energy is in the way. All of that energy that we're holding, that we're reinforcing, that we're telling ourselves, that we're telling our friends, well, I'd love to find love, but it's been 10 years. And then they stop talking, but the rest of that sentence is, so I'll probably not meet somebody because it would have happened by now. That's the story that we're telling ourselves, that's the story that we're broadcasting. And when someone comes along who might be interested in you and is like, oh, hi, do you want to go on a date? Yeah, okay, I'd like to go on a date, but it's been 10 years since I've been with someone. Great, so I've got to get through your story. And I might be like, oh, okay, well, if you'd like to go on a date, but immediately I've had to step back because you've pushed me back. Your story has pushed me back. You're not able to meet me because you've got this bag of stuff that you're carrying. Now, I'm not speaking to you directly here, but I'm saying that's how it works for all of us. And the good news is everybody's got something, you know, especially when you first go into a relationship, everybody's got some kind of fear about, oh, am I good enough for relationship? Am I good enough for this relationship? So a certain amount of it's okay, but I really don't believe anybody when they tell me that oh no, I'm never going to find another love like that. I don't believe that that's true in terms of the universe, but I do believe that they're probably going to make it true in terms of how they deal with the universe and what the universe brings to them, because they've decided, oh no, I will never find love like that again. Oh, okay, so the universe goes, oh okay, well you're not looking, okay, we had someone for you that's equal or a whole new level because you're a new person now. Oh, okay, you're not interested. Okay, well, we'll just cancel that person out. Or, well, maybe we'll just try this person and put it in front of you. They put it in front of you, but you're too busy looking at the floor, remembering your past love. So I say all of this because it's really important for us to get clear of this stuff. And the other piece that you said is that you've been working on yourself a lot. One of the things I hear a lot that I remind people to not think of is, you know, relationship is a wonderful way to work on yourself. You know, anybody out there who's married or been in a long-term partnership or even in a short-term, three-month thing, stuff comes up. And it's because you are in union with another person. You are in relationship to another person, and I know some people are in relationships with two other people or multiple relationships. All that stuff comes up. We get reflected by relationship. So I've sometimes had a few people come to me and they've said, oh, I'm not ready for a relationship because I haven't done enough work on myself. And I'm like, well, how many years have you been single? And they're like 6-7 years. Well, they'd probably have gone a lot faster if they'd been willing to take whatever they perceive about themselves that's messy or unfinished or not good enough into the relationship with another gloriously messy, unfinished, not good enough person.